Lecture number 8. The title of the lecture is How to Teach Vocabulary. Now, at the previous lecture, we have dealt with the vocabulary, yes? How to present vocabulary and what ways, what methods are there in teaching the vocabulary. Vocabulary is one of the aspects of the language to be taught at school. The number of words pupils should acquire in school depends on the syllable requirements. The vocabulary must be carefully selected in accordance with the principles of selecting linguistic materials. The true art of teaching is the ability of a teacher to stimulate pupils to work. Teaching and learning words are carried on through methods. The teacher organizes learning and the pupils are involved in the very process of learning, and the various techniques, methods are used to attain the goal, to fix the words in pupils' memory, to use them whenever they need them. Now, and this is the main aim, the main hour during when we work with vocabulary, that they must assimilate, they must use the vocabulary in their everyday speech. To present a word or introduce it to pupils means explaining its phonetic, graphic, structural aspects, meanings, and usage. Since the word consists of a sound, the teacher shows the pupils how to pronounce, how to read, or how to write it. These are the main skills in teaching. For example, if the teacher wants his pupils to learn the word orally, he instructs them to recognize it and articulate it in a sentence pattern along with the other words. For example, this is a book, or give me the book, take the book, put the book on the table. And by this example, the teacher uses different situations with the vocabulary, with the word book. There are two ways of conveying the meaning of words. They are direct or direct and translation. The direct way of presenting a word brings the learners into direct contact with the items. The mother tongue is not used. The direct way of conveying the meaning of a word is usually used when the word denotes things, objects, their qualities, movements, which can be shown to the pupils. And we call this method, or we call this presentation demonstration method, when the teacher have all objects or items to present this or that word when he introduces to the pupils. Demonstration method, we call it, when the teacher connects the English word he presents with the object. For example, he shows a book, he may show a table, read, big, sit down, stand up, and all these items, objects, are the demonstration and the objects. Rules for the teacher in presenting vocabulary, and what rules the teacher should keep in presenting vocabulary. First, while teaching pupils vocabulary, introduce words in sentence patterns in different situations. This means that every word, every vocabulary when presenting, the teacher must use it in sentence patterns or in different situations. This is the best way for pupils to remember, and in future they may also use this or that word in different situations. The next rule for the teacher: fix the new word in the pupil's memory through different exercises. This is also in practice, and our teachers in everyday lessons, they use this method through different exercises. And for primary school teachers, for secondary school teachers, there are many exercise books. For example, as for me, I always experience the exercise book by Galitsinskaya, and this is the best exercises group for pupils to study and to develop their skills and habits in when they work with vocabulary. The second rule, the next rule for the teacher, while introducing a word, pronounce it yourself and ask pupils to pronounce it individually and in chorus. And this type of, this method is maybe used with beginners or in primary schools when the teacher presents this or that word or sounds. Pupils must always work individually, and the teacher must always correct if the pupils make some mistakes. And when presenting the new words or vocabulary, much work should be done in chorus, and only when pupils read the new words individually and in chorus, I think it is the best way for pupils to memorize and to use it and develop in their future experience in learning the language. Now, this is the content of our today's lecture, how to teach vocabulary. And every teacher has their own methods, has their own experience in presenting the vocabulary. And the main aim that for every teacher is to find the most effective ways of teaching the topic of the lesson or when presenting the new vocabulary. And however the teacher teaches his subject, he must always stimulate, he must always make interest for pupils, and this is the best way for teachers to stimulate pupils in learning foreign languages. Thank you for your attention, and at the next lectures we should always concern and deal with the other problems which teachers meet during the process of teaching foreign languages at schools. Thank you.